Bloodborne Pathogens Prevention and Control Measures. There is no way to determine if someone has an infectious bloodborne disease. Workers must assume that all blood and OPIM is infectious. This is known as universal precautions. Universal precautions are followed in medical facilities and must be used anywhere occupational bloodborne pathogen hazards exist. If you encounter blood or other potentially infectious material, assume it is hazardous and use appropriate protective methods. Hepatitis B is a commonly transmitted bloodborne pathogen. Fortunately, there is a vaccine available that can minimize the risk of contracting this disease. Employers with occupational bloodborne pathogen exposure must make this available to employees at no cost. It is not required, but it is one of the safest and most effective prevention methods available. Engineering controls are devices or equipment that isolate or eliminate the bloodborne pathogen's hazard from the workplace. There are many common types of engineering controls. Sharps disposal containers provide a safe method for disposing of contaminated sharps. These objects, such as needles, razors, or broken glass, must be disposed of in one of these designated containers. Self-sheathing needles allow workers to cap needles without exposing themselves to the risk of a needle stick. Engineering controls are the preferred method for dealing with bloodborne pathogen hazards. The employer is required to regularly evaluate the availability of engineering controls and implement new controls as they become available. Work practice controls reduce the likelihood of exposure by altering the way a task is performed. The most common work practice control is frequent handwashing. Regular cleaning and decontamination of the work area is another work practice control. The employer can also prohibit unsafe practices, such as eating or drinking in a contaminated area, smoking, or touching potentially contaminated sharps. Personal protective equipment provides a barrier between the employee and potential infection. PPE is a common method of protection. However, the employer has the responsibility to try and eliminate the hazard with engineering controls. If the hazard cannot be eliminated, then PPE can be required. Common PPE include gloves, face shields, masks, safety goggles, and protective clothing. The employer will provide work area specific training on the selection and use of personal protective equipment. The workplace must be maintained in a clean and sanitary condition. The employer shall implement an appropriate written schedule for cleaning and decontamination, based upon the location within the facility, type of surface to be cleaned, type of soil present, and tasks or procedures being performed in the area. Contaminated work surfaces shall be decontaminated with an appropriate disinfectant after completion of procedures, immediately or as soon as feasible when surfaces are overtly contaminated, or after any spill of blood or other potentially infectious materials, and at the end of the work shift. Disinfectants must be EPA approved. OSHA allows for a disinfecting solution of 1 part bleach to 10 parts water. Warning labels must be placed on containers of regulated waste, refrigerators and freezers containing blood or other potentially infectious material, and other containers used to store, transport or ship blood or other potentially infectious materials. These labels must be fluorescent orange, or orange and red, and include the biohazard text and graphic. Red bags, or red containers, may be substituted for labels.